It's become very evident that there are some tragic circumstances in many seniors' homes across Ontario, and it's hit Niagara as well with a few seniors' homes with outbreaks. One in particular we'll talk about right now, Lundy Manor in Niagara Falls, with a reported 12 deaths, also 22 residents and 5 staff suffering from COVID-19. Wayne Gates, MPP for Niagara Falls, obviously something that is very concerning for you.
How it all started was the executive director's wife had put a message up on Messenger that they needed help, that they had no PPEs, they had staff that were in quarantine because of the virus, they were short staff, and they're really scared for the residents. And then I got a call from Mary, who works there, Mary Timbers, who has talked about this, so I can use her name, and told me what was going on. I then called the ED, Greg Forche, and he told me at that time, it was the Friday night, I think it was the 28th of March, that they had 11 confirmed cases, 3 that had passed, and 10 at that time that had showing signs but had tested positive. From that, obviously, my heart kind of sank, knowing that my father-in-law had actually stayed there years before. So I'd been to the home a number of times. And I called the Minister of Health. I ended up calling Minister for Seniors and Affairs. I called the Minister for Labor. And I have to say, I also called Public Health. I talked to Mr. Bradley as well as the chair. And I have to say that immediately got response from the ministers. It was very similar to the Bob Cajun thing, how that was kind of hitting the press at that time. And they immediately made some contacts with Public Health. We continued to communicate for the weekend. Over the course of that weekend, they were able to get another supplier of PSWs in there, because the ParmaMed, 14 of their workers were in isolation. And when they had the opportunity to come back, they chose not to. And the reality is this place, like a lot of this is a retirement home, not a long-term care facility, are understaffed. Their PSWs go from multiple sites. So they go from Lundy Manor to another site, maybe to do home care, which we've been calling for a long time to stop. When they got the notice around the March 12th, March 13th, instead of locking it down, they continued to, and this is really what caused the big problem there. They continued to have breakfast, lunch, and dinner in their cafeteria. And what it was, there's 100 people. So there'd be 50 at each sitting. 50 twice for breakfast, 50 twice for lunch, 50 for supper, and then they continue to run their events, play cards and that kind of stuff. So they didn't follow procedure, they didn't have proper PPEs, and then I got the call on the Friday from staff, from people outside, and we've been able to certainly highlight this. I appreciate the fact that the Premier Ford raised this on his Saturday afternoon, saying what was going on, but it's been very, very tough as over the last couple weeks. The workers have called. I've talked to the workers extensively.
How can we get to this point where we've known from day one with COVID-19 that, you know, the seniors population were going to be the hardest hit, the most vulnerable, but yet we weren't in a position to support the places where these seniors were living in larger groups?
There's a number of faults that were done here, and you know, I'm not going to talk about everybody. The one that I know about was Lundy Manor. There's a lot of things that precautions could have been taken a lot sooner than they were. As far as what governments are going to have to do going forward, we've offered solutions for a long time. We've had a bill that Bill 33 that talked time to care. And what that would do is a minimum of 4 hours per day per resident. Unfortunately, the governments of the day have not decided to pass that bill. What's come out of the crisis in long-term care is just how important PSWs are. They've been kind of looked upon just over minimum wage, not really taken as these are full-time jobs that would help. So we got to fix that. We got to make sure that the proper equipment, PPEs, are in these facilities so they can protect themselves. That was something that they didn't have at the start of this.
Thank you for what you're fighting for. And, you know, hopefully we will see changes in the future. Maybe that is one of the silver linings. It's a terrible thought, but hopefully this will prompt the government to enforce some changes in the future.
I just want to say thanks to everybody for everybody, what they're doing, all the essential workers, all the works they're doing to keep us safe. So thanks for the interview. I appreciate it.
Thank you, Wayne. That's Wayne Gates, MPP for Niagara Falls Riding. Back with more in just a moment.